Good evening. I'm in the band that's going to play a little bit later. This part of the country always reminds me about a certain guy, so I'm going to start with this one. Caught you knocking on the cellar door. I love you, baby, can I have some more? Oh, the damn is done. I hit the city and I lost my band. I've seen the needle take another man. Oh, the damn is done. Song because I love the man. I know that some of you won't understand. Milk blood to keep from running out. I've seen the needle and the damage done. A little part of it in everyone. Cause every junkie's like a sitting sore. Show for you tonight. No, it's a question. Have we got a show for you tonight? You'll see. Thank you. Thanks. Have a good one.
We'll be right back. I seem to recognize your face. Haunting, familiar, yeah. I can't seem to place it. Can I find a candle of thought to light your name? Yeah, like times are catching on. Taking place, I wish I'd seen a place, but no one's ever taken me. Your hearts and thoughts, they fade away. I can hear it. Hearts and thoughts, they
Francisco Bay Area, San Jose, Santa Clara. Got a little something to say for you, to you, and I might just have to have a sip of wine to get me through it. You know, a drummer in a band is an engine, and we've played with some of the greatest, and we still have the best in Matt Cameron. All right, that's my cue. I'm toasting to Matt Cameron right now. Soundgarden, Well Water Conspiracy, Pearl Jam for 20 minutes. Matt Cameron! Good God, that is good. Matt Cameron is a true artist, and he's a force of nature. However, even his superhero status could not prevent him from testing positive Yeah, this damn COVID thing yesterday. So we've been scrambling for 24 hours because after 25 months of, we were supposed to be here 25 months ago. 25 months ago, we've been waiting, you've been waiting. And postponing was not an issue. No, I'm sorry, it wasn't an option. And for us, neither was canceling. So, we didn't want to pull the plug, and we couldn't pull the plug. We've got our crew here, we've got the equipment here. Most important, you're here. So, lucky for us, we have some friends. And one of us, one of our friends has already been on our team this tour, the multi-talented, multi-faceted, multi-instrumentalist, playing behind the drum kit right now, Mr. Josh Klinghoffer. He's like the Shohei Ohtani of rock and roll. But we've had a lot of countless memorable gigs in Oakland and in San Francisco, and we're ready to have a gig tonight that we'll never forget. So. Let's let the shit hit the fan and hopefully it's good shit. things change. I take my hand, not my picture, spill my tincture. Boston Red Sox fan right there. Is that Kevin Euclid? I thought Kevin Euclid would get better seats than that, but anyways. Hey everybody, I can see you. Oh, I can hear you too. Oh, I know friends, and I got friends in high places. Yeah, yeah! Yesterday afternoon, this great friend of ours, he was in the middle of teaching music class, I believe, and he got a call that said, do you feel like playing an arena tomorrow night with Pearl Jam? He said, I'll call you back, I gotta change my pants. And he's been a... We've all known him forever. He was a big part of bands in Seattle. Him and Jeff have always remained very tight, and Jeff's band called Random, they put out a couple great records, and it's a three-piece. And the second piece is this great, great drummer that we get to play with tonight. And is there more? I'll tell you more about him later. But please welcome to the sacred throne a great, great drummer who's very deserving, Mr. Richard Stuverud. Mr. Stuverud. I think this Sunday is a super wolf moon coming up, which is almost as rare and spectacular as this one, the Superblood Wolfmoon. McCready doing over there on the right side. And Mr. Jeff Amon taking up the stand-up bass, yeah? Say it while I'm at it, Mr. Stump Gosser! I'm gonna tell the story on this one because there was a night, it was sometime between the Versus record and the Vitalogy record, and It was in the fall, and it was cold and rainy, and we're in Seattle, and Jeff called me up. He was at a little studio. It was called either Avast or Reciprocal. Was it Reciprocal? It was Reciprocal, where they recorded some of the early demos. But Jeff was in there with his pal Richard, and he said, hey, if you want to come down, we're just doing a little bit of writing, and it sounded good. So I got into this 64 Plymouth Red Fury, like looked like an Anaheim Angels helmet, and I'm driving, and I got the shitty little heater on, and it's raining, and the windshield wipers don't work, and I can't see shit, and I'm thinking this is dangerous, and maybe I should just turn around. My truck that I had since I was in the gas station, that was in the shop. So I was like, fuck it, I gotta go. I haven't seen Jeff in a while, which back then we saw each other so often, like a while was like 5 days. I missed my brother. So I make it there, and as soon as I walk in, they were playing this song. And I had my composition book, and I looked at it, and I grabbed like, it was like, three lines that connected to the sound of the music. And then I went in a corner and scribbled out the rest, and then we changed the length of a verse or something, and within the hour we had a recorded version of this song that came out of nowhere. And I'm so grateful that for whatever, driving in the rain. But Richard was there. I've never got to play it with him live. Thank you. I'm gonna toast to Richard. You'll see, I'll be making many toasts this evening. But I don't know if you know this part, Jeff. So on the way home, it had cut down to a bit of a drizzle, but still, I couldn't see shit driving. Luckily, it was 1 a.m. and there wasn't that many people on the road. But I just pulled over and I took down the top, and I grabbed a couple surf racks and sat on them like a booster seat so I could see over the windshield. And I put the cassette in of this new song, and I was just screaming, singing this song at the top of my lungs in the pouring rain driving back home. That was the. And this is the song, so if you want to sing it along, just pretend you're in the rain.
War's divided. There's nothing left to solve. When spoken, they can't be taken back. Walks on his own with thoughts he can't help thinking. The future's above, but in the past he's slow and sinking. To lightning, curse the day he let it go. Yeah.
voice tonight.
Good voice tonight. Good singing.
Yeah, I think one of the people that had it hardest, well, the people that had it hardest during this last two years plus has been the healthcare workers and them and teachers. I've just been thinking about it nonstop. There's got to be a few of you out there, and you don't get the credit you deserve, and you're risking your lives on a daily basis while everybody else is fucking complaining. So you know who you are, but we love you and thank you. We'll be right back. Now, there's some folks here that might be as old as me, not as many as you think. It took me a second, but this young person here, it had a sign that said, "Last time I saw Pearl Jam, I wasn't born yet." That took me a second to figure out. But you were in... Okay, you don't have to point. I mean, yeah. Oh, did you hear the Metallica thing? Did you hear that during the show? Like, you think this is crazy, playing with drummers with COVID. This is the Metallica, the great Metallica. They were in Brazil, I think a place called Curitiba. And at the Encore, this woman's with her husband and her water breaks. Have you heard this story? It's a true story, it just happened. And so they didn't have time to get her to a hospital. So they got her to a tent on the side of the stage and they delivered a baby right there. But the best part was that they were playing Enter the Sandman. And at first I heard the rumor that they named the kid James Ulrich, which I thought was great. And then they said that they wanted to name the kid Sandman. But they felt it would get bullied, that Sandman wasn't a proper name. I got a friend named Adam Sandler. We call him Sandman all the time. I say, think it through, mama. Give him a nickname, Sandman. He can pull it off. Anyways, if you're feeling, if there's anybody here that's, there's a tent over there. We got, actually near the merch booth, for an extra $20, they'll give you a C-section.
Alone in a corridor, waiting locked out.
wish I was a neutron bomb and I would never go off. I wish I were a sacrifice, but somehow still lived on. I wish I were a sentimental ornament that you hung on a Christmas tree. I wish I were the star that went on top. I wish I was the evidence. I wish I were the sound of all you beautiful people's hands on me.
Oh,
Hey, let's hear it again for Josh Klinghoffer on the drums. I heard today there was a young girl I've known since she was little. We'd always see her when we come up to play the bridge school. And I hope to see her again the next time we get to play the bridge school. I hear rumors, good ones. I mean, I could talk just about that concert and those people and those parents and those kids and that organization. But one of the... We really made so many great relationships, whether it was with other musicians, from Brian Wilson. I mean, it was endless. The amount of people that would come and we'd meet, and, you know, we were there almost every year. And but from Elvis Costello to Paul McCartney to Elton John to, but of course, Neil. And but, you know, I'd be hanging out with this little kid. It was before I had kids, she was just the coolest, and you could tell even at a young age, she had art in her eyes. And it was cool to come in today and hear that she just had, I believe, her first exhibit of her paintings. Something called the Bryant Street Gallery. But it was Amber Jean Young, who, and I think it just ended. It went up until April 30th. But you can go online and see incredible photos of her paintings, and it's so impressive. And the name of the collection was called Peggy's Garden. And she was raising money for ovarian cancer. Doing everything right, that is not a shock whatsoever, because she was just a great kid from the get-go. You know, this song's dark. It's called Daughter. It has nothing. This is the time I'm saying it's nothing about anything in real life. I just want to clarify that. You know, I think part of that artistic raising, raised in an artistic household, I think that's also something that happens a lot in this part of the country. And you should be very proud of that, and that's why some of the great art has come from here going back into the 60s. So for 60 years, you've curated some great artists and great thinkers and great minds and some great bodies too, men and women. So, this one goes out to Amber. We love you, Amber. We love you, Neil. Love you, Benny.
Alone, restless, breakfast table in an otherwise empty room. Young girl, center of her own attentions, and now mother reads aloud. Child tries to understand it, tries to make her proud. Yeah, the shades go down into her hair. Painted room can't deny there's something wrong. Don't call me daughter, not fit to. Kept will
daughter not fit to. The picture kept will remind me. Don't call me daughter not fit to be. The picture kept will remind me. Don't call me daughter not fit to. The picture don't remind me. Don't call me daughter not fit to. The picture kept will remind me.
Back in 1973, Pete Townshend was playing a guitar just like this. Maybe even this one. But Keith Moon was on the drum kit, and Keith passed out. Twice. And after the second time, they drug him off, and Pete said, "All right, is there anybody out there that can play drums?" And he said that twice. "Is there anybody out there can play drums? Somebody good." I didn't talk to the fellas about this, but because of COVID and all, we can't have quite the spontaneity to pull someone just right out of the thing, but there's got to be a couple drummers out there, and go ahead and film yourself playing a song and send it to 10 Club tonight or tomorrow morning, and then we'll get you in here and we'll test you, and then maybe play a song with us. Yeah, are you up for it? I like this guy. We have a relationship. But come tomorrow. We'll find you, and then we'll test you for COVID. We'll test you for syphilis. We'll test you for all the things. But keep it in mind and have courage. Is that you're excited about that idea? Is that your excitement? Oh, is that right? But can he play? He says he can play. Do we have Do we have security? Get him tested for the encore. Let's see what happens. Test him for the encore. I mean, it can't be that hard. You just go like this, what?
Yeah! like a picture on a sunny day. Oh my whole life, like a picture on a sunny day. Oh my whole life, like a picture on a sunny day. Oh my whole life, like a picture on a sunny day. This song was off the new record, and the new record that was was 2 years ago. And at the end, Si, would you hand me that bottle of wine right there? That one. The good one. I'm just going to take a quick second while they switch over. You know, Jeff Heyman and I believe we're the same. When we grew up, man, the Oakland A's were the coolest baseball team on the planet. And look, I'm not going to look at any notes, or there's no teleprompters or whatever, but I can tell you everybody who was on that team, like from Reggie Jackson to Gene Tennis to Joe Rudy to Sal Bando to Bert Campanaris to Ray Fossey. Did I say Reggie Jackson in the outfield? Claudel Washington, Herb Washington, only stole bases. Vida Blue, Blue Moon Odom, Catfish Hunter, Raleigh Fingers. I mean, come on! And currently, my favorite Oakland A is a guy called Steven Piscotty in the outfield. I love his dad too. It goes deep. All right, now with all that being said, just give me a second to say that I'm not a religious person, but I do appreciate that there's a few angels in the audience tonight. I love me some angels in red with the wings, and going back in 2016, there was a guy, the skipper of the Cubs, the captain, that led them to the first World Series in 108 years, and his name's Joe Maddon. Joe, I believe you're here somewhere tonight. I love you, Joe. I miss you. Because of COVID, I haven't seen you in forever. But is that Pino? Is that you? Hey, that's Joe Maddon with some red wine like that. Yeah, Joe. Hey, Pino. That's my Fratello. Me Fratello. So back in the day, when this was written, the song ends saying, there's much to be done. There's much to be done. That was 2.5 years ago. And now there's even more to be done. There's a woman with a pro-choice sign out here. I mean, are you kidding me? Of course, of course, of course, of course. So, let's remain solid and work for the freedoms that we've earned all these years.
sun of arms raised in a
is this real? Why do you demand? Leave a message and they start calling your voice one last time. Barely my field is good. Be my time by you. Would you hear me? Would you hear me?
it this way, young man. The other guys are back there auditioning the drummer. And I just wanted to run back on my own because this is where I left the wine. And it's actually become quite a friend. Hey, wait, is this a new bottle? I didn't drink the whole other one. Okay. Well, then I guess I'll... Now, actually, sir, you might have to just drink that yourself because we shouldn't be sharing. This is not going to be a wine-tasting super spreader event. Cheers to you. It's a good one. Oh, they're getting some cups. Oh, good. See, we got people on the job. All right. Well, all right, it's going to sound like... Okay, give me the... It's going to sound like hyperbole. It's going to sound like I'm placating to the crowd. This is the fifth show of the tour. We've been through San Diego, Los Angeles, and Arizona. And if anybody has been at those other shows, they know that I'm not lying. Even with what we're up against tonight and not knowing if we could even play a show today, this is the best crowd that we've had on the tour and the best crowd that I can remember. And your generosity of spirit and your spirit of collaboration tonight with us five, six guys up here on the stage, in times like these, it really means the world to us. And I can't tell you how grateful we are. I'm representing the whole band and crew when I say that. Thank you so much and deeply. So one of the things going back to, this area, this part of the country, going back to the 60s, I just wish more of the country could be as progressive, and you guys have led the way for decades. And so... This is a John Lennon song, but I'm going to sing it for all the people in other states that aren't allowing them to identify as what they feel, that allow them to experience what they want to experience, allow them to love who they want to love, no matter what gender, what race. I just can never figure out how anybody ever could condemn love.
Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall. If she's gone, I can't go on, feeling 2 foot small. And every day, oh, I can see them laugh at me, and I hear them say, hey, you got to hide your love away. Hey, you got to hide your love away.
can never win or hearing them, seeing them in the state I'm in. Oh, how could she say to me, love will find a way? Oh, gather around all you clowns, let me hear you say. This is Josh Klinghoffer back on the drums.
Waiting, watching the clock, is 4 o'clock, is got to stop. Tell him, take no more. She practices her speeches. He opens the door, she rolls over, pretends to sleep as he looks her over. She's in love with him. She dreams in color, she dreams in red. Can't find a better man. Can't find a better man. Can't find a better man.
Yeah.
band wasn't here when I was thanking you before, but I want to see their faces too. This is the best show of the crowd. They're the best crowd of the tour. This is the best show. Just when we needed you. But I've had faith in other people as well, and it didn't always work out. And I would plead with them, I'd plead with them, I'd be like, oh man, I never asked for anything, but I never asked for anything, and I don't want to ask for anything, but I got no choice. Like, I need you tonight, I need you tonight, I need you. Things are fucked up, but I need you, I need you. Don't run away. Please don't run away. 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 Don't run away.
Together. Thanks for being such a great crowd for a great man. Mr. Richard Stuverud! Goddamn, man, we miss you, but we're just trying to make the best of it. And there's gonna be one more drummer tonight. We met him when he was standing over there. And now he's gonna get behind the kit. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome one of your own, Mr. Josh Arroyo. Okay,
brother. You can take your mask off now. Yeah, you got it. So now you got to redo the shirt. You got to say Cruisin', Chamberlain, Aberzeez, Irons, Cameron,
and Arroyo.
And Klinghoffer. And Stuverud. What's that? Yeah, your shirt's gonna need to be longer. I thought you meant he needed to have bigger balls, but you needed a longer shirt. That's right. No, he's got the balls. I feel it. I feel it coming. All right, now, I don't know. Do I count this off? How do we start this thing? I think it's good.
To come this way again, no, no. On the wayside, I lied to wishes all the way, yeah. And I tried and I phoned and could have left a message, but nobody was there, yeah. On the wayside, on the front side.
They don't, yeah, I see them.
We won't forget this. We love you over here. Thank you over here. Love you over there. Thank you.
We love you back there. Thank you. Love you. Thank you. Come on, everybody, get out of here. Let's get all the drummers out here.
So many great faces.
Josh, can you pass this to the pro-choice girl, will you? All right, Josh, Mike McCready. Jeff, what's up? Another Josh. Boom Gasper. Stone Gasper. Let's take a bow.